So the 6th of January, 2026, first week back at work, got home today. The PowerOcean single phase gateway is here. It's the first time we've physically got our hands on one. I genuinely haven't opened this box. I've done the seal here on the tape, but I haven't done this yet. Like a kid at, quite literally like a kid at Christmas. Right, so template on top. Let's have a little delve in, see what else we've got. Obviously a mounting bracket, obviously a panel key, some instructions I would guess, and then in there is the actual beast itself. So let's get it out. So a nice little accessory pack too. It's got all your, what looks like your glands and everything in there. The thing I love about some of the stuff that they send is they send the bootlace ferrules and the crimps and everything with it, which not a lot of other manufacturers do that. So I think that's worth noting and making a point of. And then a nice protective cover over the actual gateway itself. So we're going to unpack this now and have a look inside. So as per the one we saw at Solar and Storage Live, you've got all your, everything's marked up for you. So generator, backup, non-backup, grid, inverter one, inverter two, and then comm. So I think that's pretty comprehensive. What I'm interested to look at, and we mentioned this at the NEC, was where the tails go, where the grid tails go into it. How easy is it to terminate those wherever it goes inside the gateway? Because that was an issue we've had with another manufacturers. They expected you to be able to twist them upside down, inside out, do the okie dokie and turn around. So you can see there, I'm just looking at the back of the unit now, you can see the template obviously perfectly lines up with the holes on this wall bracket. If we go back to that, I've turned the actual gateway upside down now. So clearly the wall bracket will be screwed to the wall like so, and it will literally, that word again, but it will mate, if you like, with the actual back of the gateway there. So that will get it secured to the wall. And then you've got another fixing point here to keep it nice and secure wherever you're going to mount it. As I alluded to, all the glands underneath, which you can't quite see there, but you've then got these on the back, which I guess is what all the accessories in the accessory pack are for when you want to fetch cables through the rear. So without needing to start drilling more holes, hopefully any access you need from the rear, you can get that sorted from there. Right, let's flip it round then. Let's put the key in it and let's have a look at the actual, the insides. Right, having flipped it back the other way, or the right way as you might say, look at this, where your panel key goes in, just slide that over and a panel key goes in there. Obviously I need my other hand to do this, so I'll try and get you down. Get you there like so. Right, so panel key in, and then this, look at that. So you can just feel it, you can just feel the quality. Okay, so to remove the front cover, you've got a screw here and you've got a screw here, and then this little bad boy is for us to lift it. So I have backed those screws off a little bit. I'm going to take them out now and have a look inside. With the screws out, the front cover just lifts off. Obviously a bit tricky because I'm doing it one-handed, but it just lifts off. It just lifts off, like so. All the warning labels on, saying, don't open me, I might not be nice to you. Right, so as a first glance in here, we're not going to go into this too much today because we're not on site. And I think this is one of those where you need to be on site and actually install it. But in layman's terms, you've got your grid gland here for your tails coming in, and they terminate into terminals one and two here. You've then got what's marked on here is your backup, which is actually the existing, which makes sense, the existing consumer unit in most cases. So then your tails will go from 5 and 6 out to the existing consumer unit. So in summary, right, terminals 1 and 2 is your AC connection coming in from the grid, from your meter. That goes into there. 5 and 6 is the AC connection going out from the gateway to your consumer unit or to your Henley block or to whatever situation you've got. But that's going to keep flowing through the gateway all the time. And that's going to keep the existing consumer unit, or as I say, whatever's already there, it's going to keep that powered up even in the event of a power cut, because of what we're going to do with this and building this. So we've got the inverter there. So once you've done that, you come to this breaker, top right-hand side of the gateway. It's a 125 amp C-type. And what we do here is we bring a live and a neutral cable from the bottom side of this, and we come down onto this DIN rail area here where we're going to put a main switch. And the idea is we're going to make our own little consumer unit here. So under that main switch, we've got a handy little neutral bar here, and there's an earth bar over here. So main switch, bit of buzz bar, breaker, RCBO, whatever it needs, and then you've got your neutral and your earth there to make sure that the outgoing side is all covered. And then that's where you come out and you power the inverter from there, which is positioned nicely underneath where your DIN rail, or where your little consumer unit, if you like, that you're going to make inside, it's smack bang underneath there. So on the face of it, it looks as though they've covered all the bases. It's worth pointing out the amount of insulation that they've put on these buzz bars here. Obviously, you're inside a control panel, so it's dangerous if you don't know what you're doing, but at least they've gone to some lengths to try and minimize the potential hazards that are inside there, which, believe me, we've worked on other panels and other gateways, and that is not the case. So that's it. Cover back on, put it back in the box, worry about it next week. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Take it easy. See you soon. So all packed up, ready for installation. Once we've connected all the AC and backup and non-backup, etc., you've obviously got to provide an alternative form of earthing, if there isn't already one there, as the comms wiring side to it as well, which we'll come on to in a video to follow.